Thank you. to give out and to seniors to send off and thank yous and things, the joy of the end of the year things, right? So it's good to see you all like this way than this way too. But so I have some awards that were chosen by chosen by the actual members of the orchestra and then also by the faculty, and so it means a lot. All of these awards mean a lot. Other than the main like orchestral award, there's one that we are going to award, a little special award that is not quite related to the orchestra, but it's one that we know the person really well, so we're going to give that award right now. The first award is the Anthony Taft Award for Music Composition, and this is awarded to a student who writes an outstanding composition or arrangement during the academic year. The recipient is Luke Rivard. Luke has been arranging music for us, transcribing music for us, and then also he's just featured his very own song cycle at his recital on yesterday, yes. Several of our players from the orchestra had a recital yesterday, and then another concert on Friday, and so we've been busy, but we're surviving, so good. The next two recipients, it's the Faculty Commendation Award chosen by the All Music Faculty, and it's to recognize the seniors who have made significant contributions to the department, ensembles, or other music-related activities. And this year's Faculty Commendation Award goes to Haley Marion and Paul Sutton. Student who best exemplifies the ideals of leadership, musicianship, and character, and this year's goes to Paige McDonald. The next is the Daniel C. Persley Award. And this is to one orchestra member, both outstanding in performance and personal character. And this year's Daniel C. Persley Award goes to Lucas Kinney. The last but not least, this is the one that the orchestra members votes every year, and this is the Dr. Philip Mason Orchestra Prize. This award goes to, presented to a student who has made most outstanding contribution to the Albion College Symphony Orchestra, Luke Rivard. Recognize our seniors, three seniors. Paul Sutton over there, if you could stand up. Trombone player who's been with us for the past, at least 2 years that I've been here, but Paul's been holding down the trombone section even with all the member change each semester. So Paul, congratulations. Next is Anissa Moore in the viola section, and she is also in heavily in the marching band as well as the symphonic wind ensemble. But Anissa joined us this year, and she's been the student member of our viola section. We've been loving that, so just make sure you find another violist before you leave. Congratulations. also been with this orchestra for the time that I've been here, and then also she's just played her recital as well as a non-music major. That's a dedication that you've been put into. So congratulations, thank you. Well, we always want to keep everybody here, you know, but we have to send up some of the students. Not only seniors, we also get some students who really like Albion, but also find other schools that support their interest. And we're very sad to send him off, but he will be in our hearts, right? And you'll be maybe come and join us. Fernando Serna is going back to Texas after the semester, so transferring to study. Computer science, oh, that's okay. But in a little more, the field that he really wants to be in that Albion doesn't offer. So congratulations for all that you have done here and good luck, best wishes for you. Okay, I won't hold you up too much. I just want to thank all the faculty and staff of Albion College, not just the music department, but also the other departments as well. We have some faculty and staff from different fields joining us, and then also we have community members, very experienced and seasoned musicians, more experienced than I am for some of you. Just being here and showing us the beauty of the lifelong learning and the beauty of just interdisciplinary collaboration. So thank you for all of your help and all of your faculty. And also, we could not do these concerts if we don't have you joining us in person and also live stream. So thank you for coming, and I hope you enjoy the second half of the music as we get more dark into Greek. All right, thank you.
Symphonic Dances, which were published in 1897. He lived from 1843 to 1907 and was a Norwegian pianist and composer who is largely considered one of the leading composers of the Romantic era. Grieg is widely known for incorporating nationalistic themes and folk sounds from his home, helping to create a stronger national identity in Norway. The inspiration for these dances came from earlier folk works collected by Ludwig Matthias Lindemann. Although it is mostly thought of as a symphonic work, the treatment of the melodies is more similar to a fantasia. It was originally written as a four-hand piano piece, but was re-orchestrated for a full orchestra by Grieg himself. With the addition of the full orchestra, we can introduce more colors into the piece. Today, as our third piece, we'll be performing Dance No. 4, Andante Allegro Risoluto, in A minor, which has very contrasting sections, from a peaceful and folk-like theme in the upper wind solos and string sections, versus the very heavy and dark brass sections, especially marked in the hemiola section, where the orchestra plays in triplets and the trombones play a duple melody, It is my personal favorite piece on our program, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. final piece of the night is Conga del Fuego Nuevo, which was composed by Arturo Marquez. Arturo Marquez was born in Sonora, Mexico in the year 1950. He later then moved into New Mexico City and studied composition at the National Conservatory of Mexico. Conga del Fuego Nuevo was composed in 2005, and the title translates to Conga, the New Fire. It is inspired by Cuban street music, and it is not the only Caribbean piece that Marquez is known for, as he also has 8 other designs, in which the second is the most popular. Anywho, we hope you enjoy the final piece of the night.